Hello and welcome to Design Space Daily, helping you learn Cricut Design Space in short and snappy video tutorials. In this video, we're going to be looking at Cricut Design Space projects, what a project is, how to open existing ones, and how to create your own. When you open Design Space, you get a screen which looks like this. At the top, there's a section called My Projects, and that's any files that you've saved from within Cricut Design Space that you've created. Underneath that, you've got lots of different categories for different types of project. And these are ones that have already been designed by other people that you can cut with your Cricut machine. For some of them, you'll only be able to use them if you pay for Cricut access, either on the monthly subscription or when you go to make it, it'll ask you just to buy the particular images that are used in that project. But there are lots on there which you can cut for free as well. If you scroll down the page, you'll see there's lots of different categories depending on what it is that you are looking to make. The ones with a little A at the top are the ones that are part of Cricut Access. If you want to just view all of your projects, you can click View All at the top or click My Projects in the very top grey bar. If you click on New Project, this opens a blank canvas for you to start designing your own template. So if we just add in some shapes quickly. This is now a project that I've created. I can save my project by clicking Save in the top right, giving it a name, and then choosing if I want it to be public or not. If a project is public, it means it can be shared with other people, but it's only shareable and searchable if you add a photo. So if you don't add a photo of your finished project, then it won't appear for others to find. If you want to keep this just for yourself, untick the public box and then nobody else will be able to find or open your project, and it won't get a shareable link, so you won't be able to share it with any other people. Once you click Save, you can choose if you want to save it to the cloud and your computer, which means that you'd be able to use it offline, or if you just want to save it to the cloud, which means you can only open it if you've got access to the internet. Okay, so now that's saved, it means anytime I open Design Space, I can open this project up and I'll get to exactly this design without having to make it again. One important thing to note is that if you've used anything that you've uploaded in this project, then it won't let you save it publicly. So I'm just gonna import this photo of my doggy. Okay, so now because this is a file which I've uploaded to Design Space in the past, it means if I go to save it and click Save As, there's now no option for me to save it as a public project. This is a security feature from Design Space to stop you from sharing copyrighted materials with other people. Design Space doesn't know whether what you've uploaded is copyright free or if you hold the copyright to it or if you're using someone else's image. So to play it safe, it has a blanket rule whether if you've put anything that you've uploaded into your project, you can't make it public. If you're on this screen and you want to have a look at the projects that have been made by other people, click the projects link in the left bar and you can now look all through them. You can search if there's something in particular you want to look for. So if I search for flower, you can see there's lots of floral projects in here and they've all got lovely photos so you can see how the finished project is going to look. You can click on a project for more information and you'll usually get some photos along the top which you can scroll through. You'll get a description and in most cases, you'll be told what materials you're going to need to create this project and also some instructions as well. Down the bottom, you'll be told if there's any images and fonts used in this project. And if you're a part of Cricut Access, so you pay the monthly subscription, then it will say that you're subscribed to the images. If you're not, then there might be a charge to be able to use this particular project. When you've chosen one you want to make, you've got two options, either Customise or Make It. Make It will send you straight to the screen where it shows you all of the mats for your Cricut and you select the material and go straight to cut it. Whereas Customise will take you to a canvas so that you can edit things if you want to. So to show you what I mean, let's just click Make It. And if you've already got stuff on your canvas, it'll ask if you want to save it or replace it. I don't need to save the test one we were working on earlier, so I'll just click replace. So this has opened that project to create those pretty flowers, and it's all ready now for me to just hit continue and go ahead and cut. It's going to complain at me now though because my Cricut machine's not turned on. But anyway, I don't want to cut it now, so I'm just going to cancel it and cancel again and go back to this project screen. So if I'd have clicked customise instead of make it, what that does instead is open up the project in Design Space. And this is useful for if you want to make any changes, so maybe change the size of what it's going to cut, or add some extra details or remove details. Whatever the changes are, you can make them from this screen, and then when you're ready to cut it, just click make it in the top right corner. You can save any changes that you make by clicking save and then save as. If we head back on over to the main projects page, I just want to show you this categories list. So in here, you've got my projects at the top, which is all the ones you've created, and underneath is my favourites. This is really handy because you can favourite projects that you see that you really like and you might want to make at a later point. Take this Teacher's Day gift basket. If I hover over it, you can see there's a link to favourite. If I press that, it's got a little star next to it. And now if I go into the drop-down and click My Favorites, it's going to filter them so it will only show me those projects that I've put in My Favorites. That's really handy for saving things for later. You've also got lots of different categories in this list as well. So you could filter by projects which are suitable for your particular Cricut machine. So let's say Cricut Maker. And all of these can be made on the Maker. You can also filter by specific types of material, for example, infusible ink, and categories and occasions, for example, Christmas. You'll notice that these projects have a share link underneath. If you click that, you can choose to share them to Facebook or Pinterest. You can also copy the project link, and that's a URL which will link directly to that project on Design Space, and you can use that to email someone a link to a project if you think they might be interested in it, or to email it to yourself if you want to open it on a different machine. But if you're going to do that, you don't actually need to do the link because you could just favorite it, and when you sign into Design Space on your other machine, it will be there right in your favorites. So that was a quick overview to the projects available in Design Space, how you can use them, search them, filter them, and also how you can create and save your own projects. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more Design Space tutorials. Thank you for watching.